I Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, can you please stand?
As we worship God, we sing, "Abide with me."
Please be seated. On behalf of the family, thank you for coming as we pay respects to Mr. Clinton Mckenzie Forbes. I've been asked to read this from Mrs. Forbes. Lots of people who sadly are unable to attend the funeral of Thanksgiving service today. Those in Canada and Jamaica, Kathleen, Beverly, Fady and Denny, and others who are watching the service online, we welcome you. The Lord is here, we will praise him. The Lord is here, we will worship him. The Lord is here. We will trust him. The Lord is here. We will honour him. The Lord is here, and he has called us to give him all the glory. So we meet to give thanks for the life of Mr. Clinton Mckenzie Forbes, who has gone on before us into God's eternal light. We are here because we knew him, and our memories will live on. We're here to listen again to the great words of the Christian faith and to consider and to give thanks for our own lives. So let's pray together. Father in heaven, we praise your name for all who have finished this life, loving and trusting in you, for the example of their lives, the life and grace you gave them, and the peace in which they rest. We praise you and thank you for the life of Clinton Forbes. Meet us in our sadness and fill our hearts with thanksgiving and praise. Dear Lord, as Jesus' followers asked him to help their friends, so we ask you today to help all those gathered here, struggling in the darkness of grief. May they know moments of peace in their pain, moments of joy in their memories. Lord of all love, be with us today in the stillness and comfort us as we remember Clinton. Be with us as we look back, remembering all who mourn. And be with us as we look forward to the journey that lies ahead. So give us the strength this day and every day. Amen. We're now going to have our first scripture reading, which is from John's Gospel. Thank you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me." In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I'm going. Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to loss. A time to keep and a time to call away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What profit hath he that worketh in that wherein laboureth? I have seen the travail which God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in. He hath made everything beautiful in his time. Also he hath set the world in their hearts, so that no man can find out the work that God makes from the beginning to the end.
Thank you. We stand and sing our next hymn. The words are in your order of service or they're on the screen. This was Mr. Forbes' favourite hymn. He loved his place and he loved to worship God. So let's really sing from our hearts. So let's stand if you're able.
The Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that He should give His only Son to make a wretch His treasure. How great the pain of searing loss! Turns His face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon a cross, my sin upon His shoulders. Ashamed I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held Him there until it was a it is finished. I will not boast in anything, no gifts, no power, no wisdom, but I will boast in Jesus Christ, His death and resurrection. Why should I gain from His reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart, His wounds have paid my ransom.
Please be seated. We're now going to have the eulogy with Josiah Isles, and Truly Isles are going to give. Thank you.
It is fitting to begin with the Jamaican motto, "Out of many, we are one." Clinton embodied this motto through his life and never held negative feelings towards others. He would go out of his way to help anyone who cared, and that is the legacy that he has left at the door. Clinton was born in Manchester, Jamaica, on the 23rd of June 1942. He was the third of 10 children born to Mrs. Enid Witter and one of three children born to Mr. James Forbes. Miss Niddy, effectively known as Mama, also adopted Cuddy and Yvonne as part of the family. This family line carries on through Clinton's siblings, Cyril, Kathleen, Bevel, Hope, Denny, Faith, and Avis. They recently lost their brother Len on the 30th of November 2021, who was a musician and record producer, and was loved dearly by his family. Clinton was a proud and loving father of four children, 14 grandchildren, and 12 great-grandchildren. He also had many nieces and nephews in the UK, America, and Canada. Our family can be traced back to Clinton's great-grandmother, Christy Seeley, who was an honoured member of the Maroons and fought against the slave trade industry in Jamaica. During his early life in Jamaica, Clinton and his maternal siblings attended Alligator Pond all-age school. He attended until the age of 16. When Clinton wasn't focused on his studies, his love for music became one of his passions in life. He would get involved in his uncle Sylvester's sound system, where he would play the latest tunes to the enjoyment of the crowd. Clinton enjoyed his life as a young man in Jamaica. Miss Niddy was a resourceful businesswoman, and they never went without. His sister recalls how supportive he was to learn and would always make efforts to help. This was part of Grandad's care and nature, and sensitive and compassionate to others. Whilst he had this side to him, he was also able to be that firm brother. They needed that if they strayed. He was a brother that was deeply loved. Clinton met the love of his life, Carmen, and they soon made plans to be married. On the 1st of February 1962, their firstborn and only daughter, Janet, was born in Jamaica. Shortly before Janet's birth, Clinton came to London in search of opportunities. He was one of the pioneers at the time who was prepared to travel abroad in pursuit of better life options. He followed his sister Gertrude and stayed with May and Gerald Morgan. Whilst in London, Clinton entered into a relationship where his son Trevor was born on the 30th of July 1962. Clinton continued to financially support family in Jamaica. On the 9th of November 1963, Clinton and Carmen married shortly after she arrived in the UK. They embarked on a new life together as one and bought their own home within a short period of time. Through their love and commitment to one another, Roy was born on the 4th of June 1965. Janet arrived in the UK in 1970. And shortly after, their final son, Gary, was born on the 3rd of December 1973 and their family was complete.
Clinton was similar to most young people in the UK. He spent most of his time during the week working and spending his free time with his good friends, Donovan, Mr. Godfrey, and Val. These close friends, along with his sisters, May and Gerald, formed his primary network. Clinton spent most of his working life in the construction industry, working for Haymills. He had this role until he experienced a stroke 20 years ago, which led to his retirement on health grounds. This gave him more time to spend with his expanding family, his many grandchildren and great-grandchildren. His health was managed by medication and was stable for a time, but in 2019 he had a fall which led to a period of time in hospital. He recovered from this fall but went on to suffer another one that showed a bleed on the brain. But despite this, our granddad was a rock, still smiling and happy to see everyone who walked through his door. His strength saw him recover time and time again. Granddad was a man who taught us many things. How to treat people, how to talk to friends and family, how to welcome someone to your house, how to love people. There were so many little things that we love him for. His smile would light up a room when he saw his family, and his whole body would smile. I've never seen him angry in my life. My mum was talking last night and she was saying that she'd never been told off from him at all, ever. Not once. We have a lifetime of joy-filled memories from Granddad. Him and his polos that he always had in his pocket. Asking for a polo, you'd get one. The hanky he always had in his pocket. The way he always looked smart, shirt, tie, suit, shoes always polished. Him spinning the vinyl in the front room, which we weren't always allowed in, but we could hear him. Us begging him to take us to the sweet shop, and he would go via the bookies. Him reading his paper and checking the pools or the races with his little mini little pen that he used to get from the bookies, the little tiny ones. He had 100 of those around the house. Him slipping us money when mummy wasn't looking, and then us buying sweets for those. Those wonderful words you would hear when you go in the house, and he'd say, "Are you hungry? Go look in the garage." And then you go in the garage and it's like, what's in there? It's like Aladdin's cave. Everything was in there. Especially the Jaffa cakes. There was always Jaffa cakes at Grandma and Granddad's house. But the main things were, the way that he would say goodbye with Grandma at the door. Even to this day, they walk you to the door. No matter how cold it is, we're freezing, raining, they'll walk you to the door and they'll stand there waving at you until you're long gone down the road. I used to travel from Hertfordshire to Harlesden, to Willesden, just to get a haircut. Just so I can go and see Grandma and Granddad. Just for 5 minutes, just to say hello. And then I go and get on the train again. At that and Grandma's dinner. It would take me all day, but it was worth it. We've always had that second home with Grandma and Granddad. And I know a lot of you in here have had that same experience as well. You go to their house and you're always welcome. He's helped so many people along the way. Friends, family, and even complete strangers. We all have these memories of him. He will live on through us all, but especially through his family, who are his world. I can see him now, in my heart, at peace. That love feels smile. That smile that whenever you said hello, would just beam up on his face. Just waving at the front door. Either waving you hello or waving you goodbye. He was a good man all the time, good through his bones. And that's why, to me, and to so many others in this room, he was a great man. We'll miss you, Granddad, but we'll see you again. Don't worry about Grandma. We'll look after her for you. And we know one day, you'll be waving at the door again as you welcome us back home. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. We're now going to have, I think, Noel Robinson, is he here? I think he is. Okay. We're now going to have Donovan, who's going to share some special memories. Thanks. Yeah, the service has been live streamed on YouTube, not Facebook. We're not having that. Okay, well, I thought it'd be good if we have some open sort of short tributes, and I think Mr. Archery is going to kick off as on behalf of the fellowship, the church here. So if anybody else wants to say just a few words, but not long, because we've got other things to get on with in the service. But thanks, Mr. Archery.
Pastor, members of the Clinton family, members of this church, and all friends, may the grace of God through His Son Jesus Christ be with you all at this sad time. Mr. Clinton Forbes was a faithful member of this church. He was somebody who didn't like to say no if you asked him to do something. Years ago, when we had to replace the old-fashioned lighting system in this church, we had to erect certain scaffolding frames to go to the ceiling to replace the lighting that was ruptured. And when I asked him if he's got time to come and assist us, because we need five members of the church to do that at that time, and Mr. Clinton Forbes, providing that he was available, he was the first to arrive. That was the sort of person he was. I and you all here will come to pay your last respect to that great man. I give thanks for the time that I have known him, the years that I have known him, because the great God has only given us Mr. Clinton Forbes. He had lent us Mr. Forbes. He didn't give us Mr. Forbes. And he decided, because of the great God, to call him home. And you all and I are grateful to the great God for the time that we had him. He was a very well independent person, well liked within the walls of this church. And he never failed to do anything. He will even ask before he is asked. Over the years, he has kept his faith, and he has now crossed the River Jordan. He has left a trail of beautiful memories, which we all will cherish for the years to come. He will be greatly missed by all of us. And may his soul rest in peace, in God's keeping. Amen.
Thank you. Anybody else want to say just a few short words?
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for coming. I'm grandma and granddad's, one of their grandchildren. I literally grew with them. Everything like Josiah said, Granddad never said no. I never heard Granddad, she never shouted, nothing. The funny thing is, I always say to Grandma, how you like last so long? Grandma said, 60 years we're together, we still don't understand each other. That's how it works. Anytime Grandma start, Granddad just nodded his head and said, Granddad never argued, nothing. I never heard my granddad ever say a horrible word about someone. Anytime I used to go to the house and he wasn't there, I said, Grandma, where granddad gone? Oh, he's gone bookie shop. When granddad come back and I said, oh, you got to see Mrs. William Hill. And granddad used to laugh all the time. Granddad, he was a lovely soul. You know, he was perfect. And I know it's hard to say that nobody's perfect, but my granddad, he was the perfect, most perfect man I've ever met in my life. The unconditional love that he showed me, nobody's ever shown me that. So, you know, it was a blessing to have him, and I'm happy that all my kids, you know, were here to meet him, because I'm done now. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Nope. Okay. Well, we're very quickly going to look at this passage from John's Gospel, chapter 14. Mr. Forbes, indeed, was a gentleman, kind and supportive, and never wanted a fuss, was generous. It was only recently that I discovered that every so often in church, he slipped some of the children £5 notes. I never got one for some reason, but... My last meeting with him is we're always welcome at Sherrett Green Road. They talked about using the church for your 60th wedding anniversary, and sadly not to be. Even when Mr. Forbes was unable to attend church, he always asked after people. He always asked for a new sheet because he wanted to be kept up to date with what was happening in church. He asked after Chaz, Claire and the little girl, who were members of this church who went to live abroad in Tasmania. In this passage in John chapter 14, we have very familiar and reassuring words. Whenever I travel back to Scotland, I like to be prepared. I check the trains to see if they're running, if it's a bank holiday, is there any trains? How will I get to Luton Airport to fly back to Scotland? Working out the times and arrival at the airport, and have I got enough time because I don't want to miss my flight. A few times there's been no trains, and I've kindly been given a lift. Have I got my passport? Though the last few times that I've travelled to Scotland, I haven't needed my passport, and nobody has even asked to see it. Jesus, in this passage, is telling us about heaven and how we get there. That Jesus is like our passport, and he doesn't want anyone to miss going to heaven. Heaven is far more beautiful than Scotland or Jamaica or Barbados or Ghana or wherever you're from. All these places, I'm sure, rolled into together. In this passage, we have these words, do not let your hearts be troubled. And these were reassuring words to the disciples because they were about to indeed face trouble. We should not be surprised when life does not go how we want it, because Jesus later in John 16 would say, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Whatever happens in life with its ups and downs, its problems and difficulties, joys and sadness, we are to trust in Jesus. And that's what Jesus is getting at in this famous passage. Despite all the worries and the cares and the problems, the sad times, he is with us because he's promised never to leave us nor forsake us. We are to trust him with our future. We are to trust him in the present. A happiness and a joy will come. I know that Mr. Forbes has gone to heaven and that I will see him again one day. which is far better. We look forward to that day when we will get there. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or paining, for the old order of things has passed away. We don't like to think about death, and even as a child, my parents kept me. I wasn't able to attend any funerals until I was 18. Woody Allen said, "I'm not afraid to die. I just don't want to be there when it happens." In this passage, we are told that heaven has many dwelling places. There is room for everyone. Jesus tells us that it is his Father's house. These dwelling places will last forever and ever. I'm not sure how many times you have moved in your lifetime. The average time that people move in the United Kingdom is 7 times. You move 7 times in your lifetime. And as I was counting all the times that I've moved 13 times. So more than the average. But when we get to heaven, there will be no moving. It will be permanent. It's lasting and forever. Jesus also tells us that heaven is a prepared place. I have gone and prepared a place for you. My sister and nephew Lewis and my mum, just before Christmas, were all excited because they made the journey with all their COVID tests and everything else sorted out, which was a bit of hassle. They went to Lapland to see Father Christmas. And when they came back, they showed me the pictures and how good the holiday was and how they want to go again this year to see Father Christmas. I've never been, but I can look at the pictures, but it's not the same, is it? Jesus here in this passage is telling us what heaven is like. He's gone to prepare a place for us. It's going to be the most amazing place. We can trust that Jesus is no liar, that we can trust him because he came from heaven and he's returned to heaven and he is coming back from heaven one day to take us to be with him if we've trusted in him as Lord and Saviour. Thomas, who often gets a hard time in Christian circles, but I think sometimes that's unfairly, he asks this question, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And I'm glad that he asked that question because Jesus answers that question and tells us, "I am the way." He doesn't point to someone else who is the way. He says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." So without shadow of doubt, the only way to heaven, to be with Jesus, is through King's Cross, the King who died on a cross that we remember all our days. So in a world where people question and debate what truth is, who is telling the truth, what has happened, Jesus says, "I am the truth." Truth is the opposite to falsehood, to error, to deceit. We are to trust in Jesus. He is the beginning, the middle, and the end. In him we must set out, go on and finish. As the truth, he is the guide of our way. As a life, he is the end of it. So heaven is a real place. Heaven is a loving place, but also heaven is an exclusive place. Anyone can go there, but we have to go through King's Cross and ask for forgiveness for all the wrong things that we've said and done in our lives. I came across this story recently, and some of you have heard it before, but it's good. A story of a Spanish father and son who had a difficulty and problem, and the son decided that he would leave home, so he ran away. So the father set out to find him, and he searched for months to no avail. Finally, in the last desperate effort to find his son, the father put out an advert in a Madrid newspaper, and the ad read, "Dear Paco, meet me in front of the newspaper office at noon on Saturday. All is forgiven. I love you, your father." And the Saturday came, and 800 people called Paco turned up to see their father. It speaks to us of the love of God, wanting us to return to him. It tells us of love. A tombstone epitaph reads, "Pause, stranger, when you passed me by. As you are now, so once was I. As I am now, so you will be. So prepare for death and follow me." A passerby read these words and underneath scratched the response, "To follow you, I'll not consent until I know which way you went." Which way are we going? As we thought very briefly of this passage, Jesus saying, "I am the way, the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Amen. We're now going to have a poem which has been specially written, so called New Journey.
Hello everyone. For those who don't know me, I'm Remnika. I'm the grandchild of Grandma and Granddad. My poem's called His New Journey. Don't think of him as gone away. His journey's just begun. Life holds so many facets, this world is only one. Just think of him as resting from the sorrows and the tears in a place of warmth and comfort where there are no days and no years. Think how he must be wishing that we could know today how nothing but our sadness can really pass away. And think of him as living in the hearts of those he touched, for nothing loved is ever lost, and Clinton was loved so very much.
Thank you. Now let's pray together. So God of mercy, hear our prayer for all those whose lives during this past few years have been overturned by COVID-19. For those who have suffered and those who still struggle. For those who have lost loved ones as a result. For those in our hospitals and health centres, exhausted by the demands made upon them. Those in our nursing and residential homes who have been so vulnerable and felt so isolated. Our country, our society, our world is broken, hurting but hoping, fearful of the future yet praying for a miracle. We are in the presence of God and in need in our sorrow. We are in the presence of God and thankfulness for the life we knew and shared. We are in the presence of God seeking hope and courage for the future. We are in the presence of God who has promised to be with us till the end of time. Father, we thank you that we can turn to you and know that you understand, that we can open our hearts to you and know you'll never turn us away, that we can share our feelings of brokenness and know that you will hold us forever. Father, we thank you for those who have offered us love and care, those who have shared our tears and held us gently. Father, we thank you for all that they've done for us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Thank you that through his life, death and resurrection, you have shown us that your love simply has no limit, and that when we put our trust in you, we receive the promise of your eternal joy. So Father, we ask for your help as we place Clinton Forbes into your hands. Give us peace in the knowledge that in your keeping, he is safeguarded, content and whole. Surround all of us at this sad time with your unending love. Do not let grief overwhelm us or be unending or turn us against you. May we find peace, love and hope because of today. May we know that what it means to walk with you all the days of our life. And at the end, we may by your grace rejoice to be in your presence forever. Father, we cannot receive your kingdom unless we come to you as little children. So we thank you for the life of Clinton Forbes. All the memories that will live on, we thank you for him. Now in love, trust and thankfulness, we give him back to you, knowing that in your keeping he is safe and happy and complete and whole. We thank you that all life is a gift from you. And today we come to thank you especially for the life of Clinton Forbes. So Father, help us, be with us, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. We say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Our kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Roy is going to come and give a personal tribute. Thank you. We're going to finish by singing What a Friend We Have in Jesus. So please stand if you're able to.
To be in earnest prayer.
Soon in glory bright unclouded, there will be no need for prayer. Rapture, praise and endless worship will be our sweet portion there.
Again, on behalf of the family, thank you for coming. There's details where the interment is at Paddington Old Cemetery, and then back here for refreshments after the interment. So let's pray. For loving the world and knowing our names, thank you, God. For your strength that fills us and your love that heals us, thank you, God. For your presence with us and your hand that leads us, thank you, God. And may God give to you all whom you love his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Please remain standing.
Hello everyone. The Paddington Cemetery is off Wilsden Lane towards Kilburn.